May I now humbly request Sri Manik Sarkar, Honorable Chief Minister Tripura State, to address the gathering.
Good afternoon, everybody present here. It is undoubtedly a very significant function being organized by this trust. The Honorable President of this function, distinguished guests sitting on the dais, respected elders, my mothers and sisters, brothers and friends, and of course, my beloved students. At the very outset, I would like to convey my heartfelt warm greetings to you all on behalf of the people of Tripura. I would also like to pay my homage to the great memory of Quaide Milleth, to pay respect to him. This trust has been constituted. I don't like to tell much about him because I know very little also about him. But I have been listening to the speakers one after another. They have depicted his life, his works, related to the Indian independence struggle and for the further advancement of our country, and particularly with regard to the development and prosperity of Tamil Nadu. I think the lessons we have drawn from his life through his tireless activities for the great nation India should be taken to the younger generation of our country, and it should not be confined to Tamil Nadu alone. I think it should be taken throughout the country. Because this sort of life can ignite the young minds of our country, who are nowadays in different manner trying to be misled, and particularly very calculative mood is on to make our students and younger generation self-centric. Think for yourself. You need not think for others. You need not think for your country. You need not require to know what is happening in other parts of the hemisphere, globe, world. You should confine yourself. This is not real education. Education does not mean participating in rat race for acquiring some numbers. Education means building of character. So in building character, the experience of life from Quaide Milleth may be a great help to our students and younger generation. That's why I request the LS educationist and the intelligentsia of our society, they should try to take this message from their life experience to the students and youth community of our country. We have been passing a very complicated and critical phase of our country. Nowadays, a section of people of our country, they have started voicing the slogan that India should be converted as a Hindu Rashtra. And they have been, according to them, narrating the history of civilization 2,000 years back, not in India, throughout the world, there was no other religion other than Hindu religion. Where from they got this history, we do not know. And in India, they have been saying, those who were non-Hindu residing in India, they shall have to be converted to Hinduism, living their present religious belief. Maybe Muslim, Christian, Buddhist, Sikh, Jain, etc., etc. And not only this, in different parts of the country, at least during the last 3 years, they have been trying their level best to put pressure on the minorities, particularly Muslims and Christians, to create panic among them and convert them in Hinduism. More than 17 crores Muslims are residing in India. I think this is second largest after Indonesia in the world. Even it is higher than Pakistan and present Bangladesh. They love this country. They believe this is their country. If they have not that belief, they would desert India, either went to Pakistan or erstwhile East Pakistan or present Bangladesh. Years after years, they have been residing in India. Even we have taken birth in the soil of India, even before that. Where they will go? These people who are preaching for converting India into Hindu Rashtra, they have been saying, if they don't like to convert themselves, they will go to Karachi, Afghanistan, or Middle East. What sort of approach is this? Christians, I think in India there are more than 4 crores. Where they will go? The Buddhist, I think they are also more than 3.5 crores. Where they will go? If you calculate, the religious minorities have been residing in India nowadays, I think their total number may cross more than 30 or 32 crores. How many countries are there in the world who are having The total population of 30 or 32 crores, very few. What is this? This is nothing but to divert the people from the problem, basic problems they have been facing in their day-to-day life. Prices of essential commodities is hiking like anything. It has become order of the day. The value of rupee is going down. I think this is highest since independence during last 70 years. Inflation, particularly with regard to food items, essential food items, that is also increasing. There is no check. Farmers, particularly peasants, they have been committing suicide during last 3 years. Percentage of suicide by the farmers or peasants, it has hiked by 34% in the last year. More than 12,000 farmers committed suicide in different parts of the state, including Tamil Nadu, but not one in Tripura. Unemployment problem. It is galloping, mounting like anything. I think at this stage, it is more than 25 crores. Educated, semi-educated, they are the large chunk of this unemployed youth. Who will build the country? An old man, he or she may have love for the country. They want to prosper the country, but because of their age, this is only natural, they cannot do much. The strength, vigor, lies with the youth, but there is no planning to utilize this force, this strength for the development, for the prosperity of our country. Corruption is galloping like anything. One after another chief ministers of different states, I don't like to name them, because this is not the proper platform. Complaints are coming. Cases are pending. You know which party they belong? I don't like to dispel all these things. More than 32 lakhs of rupees deceiving the country, handful of monopoly capitals, they have taken this money outside the country. This money is not, there is no attempt to take it back in India. And their names are not also being published. We do not know what is the problem and trouble behind publicizing their names. People must know at least who are robbing the country, who are robbing us. In India, very recently, we came to know only 41 corporate houses. They have taken loan mostly from the nationalized banks of our country, of about 12 lakhs crores of rupees. Now, preparation is on to declare this money as non-performing asset. And by this time, more than 2.5 crores of that money has been declared. They have actually given relief, those who have taken this loan from the nationalized banks. But a poor farmer, about whom I have already mentioned, committing suicide, mortgaging his land, taking money as loan with a high cost from the nationalized banks, while he is failing to repay this in time, his all assets are being confiscated by the authority, bank authority, with the help of police and other organs of the administration. But the big corporates, 41, their names also have not been published by this time. So far, nobody is touching them. Nobody is touching them. More than 70% people of our country, they are residing in the countryside, villages, even in Tamil Nadu. The villages have been suffering from inadequacy of basic infrastructure like connectivity, safe drinking water, electric connection, schools, primary healthcare facilities, irrigation, shelter, clothing. People are dying like anything. Starvation deaths are taking place. But in our budget, allocation is being cut one after another year. Education and health, these are the two very important components on which human resource can be developed. You know, more than 35 crores of our population, they are still illiterate. They cannot write their name. Only on thumb impression, they are collecting their wages. This is the state of affair. But despite all these things, 5% of the yearly budget is not being allocated for the development and expansion of education or healthcare facilities. So people are getting restive. They don't like to wait year after year. They have been earning lessons and experiences. So they are trying to be mobilized, united among themselves, irrespective of their caste, color, and creed. This is causing danger for the people who are running the show from the seat of power. That's why to disturb this unity, disturb this understanding of unity, this diversion in a very calculative manner is taking place in the name of so-called Hindu Rashtra. I have no hesitation in saying so. But this is not the teaching of Hindu religion. Not only in Hindu. Either it may be Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Jain, Buddhist. No religion spread venom against any other religion. Religion teaches people to love each other, Religion teaches he who is suffering most. If you have ability, please try to stand by his or her side. Through your service, if you see he or she is smiling, then you can believe. If you have believe in God, that your God is actually smiling. You need not go to any temple, any church, or any mosque. Love the people, respect the people, try to help the poorest of the poor. So this is the teaching of all religions. I have very little knowledge about religion, but I have also read some books on religion. That's why I'm telling this. What is going on in our country? It means what? The very concept of our constitution, in framing, the constituent assembly was constituted, where Quaide Milleth was one of the members and played a very glorious role. The main essence of our constitution now is under severe attack. India, sovereign, democratic, socialist, secular republic. Democracy and secularism moving side by side. Democracy means oxygen. Without oxygen, human being cannot survive. If there is no democracy in this society, society cannot progress further. So without democracy, secularism cannot flourish. Without secular fabric of our society, our unity, integrity, an advancement of our civilization cannot be possible. In this situation, the remembering this sort of people and involving our students and youth through this sort of initiative to learn lessons from their life is very, very important and relevant. That's why I am again congratulating this trust for taking these steps. I am not congratulating them because they have awarded us. I know my limitation. So many things have spoken about me. I am conscious about my limitations. I have many more miles to walk. Every day I am learning lessons. And this world is nothing but a school of learning lesson. Till one takes his last breath. This is the teachings. So, particularly because this is educational social trust. And particularly, this trust is taking care of the students. And I am really impressed, highly impressed, that they have been taking care of scheduled tribes, scheduled caste, OBCs, minorities, at a very low cost. These boys and girls are providing facilities for their education. While our government, either in the state or in the center, I am not talking of Tripura. In Tripura, education is free up to general college level. I have not come here to explain the program being implemented in Tripura. That will be a narrowness on my part. So please pardon me. So in this situation, a trust they have undertaken this responsibility on their shoulder. It's a very, very wonderful steps they have taken. But what I would request them, and particularly I am definite, the principal is sitting on the dais, and other faculty members of this educational institutions, they are also here. And what I have been observing, parents are also here. Father and mothers are also here. You see, today's student is our future citizen. If they are not properly is groomed, our future will bound to be bleak. While a section of our society is trying to destroy everything of our country. So in this situation, students should be taught like that way so that he or she develops as a good human being. Only scoring 90%, 95% number in the exam and becoming engineer or doctor or big bureaucrats is not suffice. It does not suffice. We need good human being. Good human being means truthful. Don't tell a lie. Free of greediness. They have love and respect for the people, irrespective of caste, color, and creed. They have love for the children. They have love for the country. The sense of patriotism shall have to be developed and inculcated in their minds. And this teaching should be taken to them. Mother and nation, mother and country, there is no division. Some people are trying to develop this sort of division. Well, no. There is no division. If we fail to inculcate this teaching, these ideas into our children, who will take responsibility to lead the country for its prosperity in future? That's why I do believe distrust, they will not leave any stone unturned to inculcate this sort of value-based education in the children of ours. They might be hailing from Tamil Nadu, some of them may come from other parts of India, even from Tripura. State, the geographical area should not be barrier. Children are children. And the sense of world brotherhood shall also have to be developed. Like sky, like sea. Sky cannot be divided, and water of sea cannot be divided. This understanding is nowadays required to be developed in the minds of our new generation. If we fail to discharge these responsibilities, how we can claim that we are teachers? You are teacher, not for helping the score number alone. You are teacher for building real human being. And in this regard, our mother have to play a very, very vital role. Mother is the first and best teacher. If from within the family, mother and the parents, if they take this initiative and it is supplemented and complemented by the teaching committee, either in the school or in the college or in the university, then this will be able to overcome this complicated phase, complicated situation being faced by the country, society and our civilization. I do hope that this trust will, they have been doing, but again I would say they will take lead to show path not only in Tamil Nadu, in other parts of the country. With these few words, I like to conclude. Thank you all. Take my respect and notes.
Sir, one kid. Sir, Haji Marayar, sir.